しいでしょ。あのなんかね、なんか日本でいうあのなんかなんとかかのなんかのあのなんとかなんかアカデミックじゃなくてなんか、うん、あのアカデミックあのなんか国際化とかのあの。
まあ、あの
コーディネーターとかやってる
パートリーアシスタントとパートリーリサーチャーパートリ
ー
オフィサーアドミニスター。はい、わかりました。パンクチャーでね、はい、どうぞ。
Welcome everybody. My name is Sayabuchiwara. I'm the director of Prince Takamado Japan Center for Teaching and Research. And this year, we are very lucky to be chosen as one of the sites for the annual lecture funded by the Japan Foundation Toronto and the Japan and Studies Association of Canada. This talk is also co-sponsored by the Prince Takamado Japan Center, University of Alberta, and the Center for Japanese Research at the University of British Columbia. Prince Takamado Japan Center respects and promotes racial, ethnic, and religious diversity on campus, and the University of Alberta respectively acknowledges that we are situated on the Treaty 6 territory, traditional lands of First Nations and Indian people. So just to remind you, we are live streaming this lecture. So we might, after this lecture, we might get other questions from other campuses in Canada. So today's speaker is Professor Masahiro Hamashita. He's a professor emeritus of Kobe College, Nishinomiya, Japan. Professor Hamashita is a specialist in Japanese aesthetics and art, and he taught at one of the most recognized women's universities in Japan for many years, and he's an author of more than 10 single and co-authored books in the field of gender and art and aesthetics, and taught in internationally in Italy, China, Australia, and Scotland. So today, his talk combines his research with his long-term association with women's education in Japan. So the title is A Glimpse into Women's Education in Modern Japan. So let's go.
Thank you very much. Hello, everybody. Thank you for coming. It's my great pleasure and honor to come to here as a guest speaker, thanks to Japan Foundation Toronto and a very kind arrangement of Fujiwara-san, the other staffs here. Of course, I'm afraid I am worthy of this honor, but I try my best to give you some talk about this topic. The title of my speech is officially A Glimpse into Women's Education in Modern Japan. However, I am not a specialist of women's studies. Of course, I never be a misogynist nor a passionate lover of beautiful women, in particular with blonde hair, as Mr. Trump. But I have long working at some women's college. Probably that's why such a request of title offered to me. And to be frank with you, I published a book on women's studies. I hope to dedicate this book afterwards to Fujiwara-san was sent to this library. The title of my book is Power of Womanhood and Its Transfiguration, A Challenge to Women's Studies, treating the concept of Aphrodite. Two ideas to concept of Aphrodite, Uranian, Aphrodite, Pandemos, and the interpretation of Sophocles' Antigone, and Japanese very, very historical drama, Dojoji, and on Rafkadio Han, and Natsume Soseki, and Miyaza Kenji. Of course, most of you will not be familiar with what I mentioned now, but I try to clarify in this book not a viewpoint from feminist aesthetics or feminist art history or the gender studies. It's based on my own concept of womanhood. The title, Imo no Chikara, I will mention afterwards, in particular at the conclusion. If you have some knowledge, it reminds you of the Yanagida Kunio's very great book, Imo no Chikara. Imo means not a sister, younger sister, but womanhood itself. Anyway, probably as published such a book, the topic will be requested in this way. So my specialty is aesthetics, rather historical aesthetics, because I'm very much interested in the art history, and my starting point of research on the 18th century British aesthetic, Edmund Burke and Shaftesbury and etc., etc. So extend my research work into Japanese aesthetics for many reasons. So nowadays, my interest in modern Japanese people's interest in aesthetics. Today I will not speak about the topic in detail, but interesting enough, Japan is the place or a nation where the aesthetic as a department of university was established for the first time in the world. almost 20 years in advance to the University of Paris, which means the Japanese people's interest in the aesthetic itself, or the science of art and so on. So considering the meaning of aesthetics, of course, as a historical study, as a discipline, and at the same time, the meaning of aesthetics in contemporary world, I have been wondering why Japanese people, mostly modernity, adopted aesthetics so eagerly. Today's talk will, to some extent, related with such a background. Now, following the panel, and I prepared a very, very shabby handout, not a perfect one, but I hope it will offer some contribution or some convenience to catch up or follow my talk. So, from the title, there are many problematic concept and academic situation. So, of course, the title women itself may be a kind of enigma, not only to men, but historically. But today, of course, I will not discuss further the concept of women. And next, education itself is a very, very problematic concept. So, of course, I try to translate many Japanese word and kanji into English to make myself understood easier by you. But education, generally a translation of course, if you don't know kanji, please admit or be generous. The 教育 is a translation, maybe education, but at the same time, it can be translated shūyō. So in such a translation culture in modern Japan, many confusing and sometimes misleading thought and the, in a sense, discipline, academic challenge. But through such a dilemma, it's a Japanese characteristic. We are investigating what the truth is, what the situation is. Anyway, title is, of course, the women's education. But when we discuss the history of education of women, I don't want to imply always the official or governmental system. But also, we must pay attention to the home education, mostly influenced by parents and relatives, brothers and sisters. And if kyoiku or modern education is to some extent a result of adopting Western culture, while shūyō may be implied some tradition of a Japanese way of educating young girls and ladies, so the, some knitting or how to do the household work, etc. And shūyō sometimes means a way to the, some virtue, which means the virtue of lady, fujin no toku. So from the title, we will be so much confused. And furthermore, I mentioned in title, modern Japan. Modernity itself so much problematic and very point about which we should discuss more and more. Of course, simplifying, Japanese modernity may be interpreted as starting through Meiji Shin, the Meiji Restoration, but Edo period, I think we should not call it pre-modern, of course, feudal age. So if we say modernity, of course, we must keep in mind the continuity and disruption between Edo period to Meiji period. So if you think about Edo period, which has been notorious as a feudal system, so the concept of predominance of men over women, so-called danson johi, and male chauvinistic mentality all over Japan, and Confucianism leading macho society and class segmentation, the no choice for choosing jobs, etc. And for if I treat one example, one topic, you know, the concept of in Japanese mekake, mistress. This is another problematic concept and practice among Japanese family, in particular husband to wife relationship. So even already in Confucius idea, it's a kind of a base of idea of predominance of men over women. In Mengsi, Moshi, in Moshi, we can read, quote, wife and mistress live in the same room, which allows such a mistress existence. And in one book written by a Japanese Confucian thinker, he allows and admits the existence of mistress because what is at most important to a samurai family, it is get the successor, inheritance. So if one woman except wife, official wife, can bear the successors, then such a practice should be justified. So it's a very, very Edo period mentality. Then if we say modernity, after the Meiji Restoration, there is a greatest attack on the practice or custom or existence of the mistress by so-called enlightened thinker like Fukuzai Ukichi and others. So yes. So I like to treat some basic features implicitly found in Japanese history and culture. So of course, simplifying, I like to mention the concept of the sun goddess. Amaterasu-Ohmikami, which may be regarded as original existence, original god of Shintoism, it was or she was the sun goddess. Except Japanese history, Japanese mythology, or Japanese culture, some Polynesian or some, according to your expression, First Nations people has kept the sun goddess. Mostly, the sun mythologically regarded as man, god. So the Sima Guan in China says, man is the sun, the woman is the moon. It's a very, very common idea about the sun god. But such a female element can be detected in Japanese culture and mentality, probably so. And also the concept of creation, that you know the Old Testament, always man is first, then women will be created or produced through the rib of man, according to Old Testament. It's a very discriminating idea. So the matrilineal is one features of Japanese culture, idea to say. So primitive matriarchy is always contrasted with civilization means the idea that the civilization means paternity, patriarchal community. So still, we will easily find in Japanese society and community double standards. On one hand, women play a very greatest role. On the other hand, mostly politics or economical activity related, male dominant society. The immodernity, Hiratsuka Raicho claimed that since the beginning, initially, women itself are god and sun goddess. Then she says, nowadays in modernity, women are regarded as moon, but originally, women has been sun. But manifest, very interesting. Here, yesterday I just arrived in Alberta and Edmonton, around the moon. The sun is so passing and so bright, so beyond gender, I think. Very, very interesting light. But in Japan, in a climate very moderate and probably sun never menace of heat, but always a good condition of producing some accomplishment. So self-convincing women writer believed we are originally a tile, which idea we can understand easily. Of course, pre-modern age from ancient medieval, we can trace the culture bloom, I'm afraid the handout at the hand is different from the panel I showed. I wonder why. So, sorry, but please listen to what I will talk. Not a crucial point of my talk, but I like to mention for illustration. So, back to my talk. Considering the cultural bloom, Heian period, the ancient time and medieval days, women worked very prolifically, novels, essays, diary literature, such as Murasaki Shikibu's The Genji Tale, Seisho Nango's Makuhanosoushi, and so on. Of course, emergence of the samurai clan and samurai class, the cultural concepts are little changed. Still, there are very outstanding lady, powerful persons, which had been the aid to his husband as a general or a shogunate, and such as wife of Minamoto no Yoritomo, the 20th century, Hojo Masako, and the shogunate Ashikaga Yoshimasa's wife, Hinotomiko, 15th century, and Tokugawa Shogun's in Japanese, Menoto, mother-like lady, Kasuga no Tsubone, etc., etc. We can easily pick up such a lady. Of course, their cultural activity is different, but anyway, as the existence of the womanhood, they show power. And even in Edo period, already exists a textbook for education of women. So women's literary, women's university, to promote a concept of a good wife and a wise mother. Now, we enter the modern Japan, and please look your handout. Probably handout is clearly printed out. So modern Japan itself are very important topic of debate and discussion. So at that time, Meiji government tried to establish, following the Western powerful countries model, so-called nation-state, and systematize legally, military, and education, and so on. Probably basic fear of leaders of Meiji government, maybe, to confront with all nations, which at that time Japan as a country was menaced to become a colony of some powerful country of the West. So independence of the state, independence of the nation would be a primary concern. And to realize it, the industrialization and the powerful army and importing Western learning was a greatest policy of the government. So one slogan was away from Asian order into a European order, European American order. So as a result of a kind of enlightenment idea of Western nation state, Japanese government at that time, Meiji government, promoted the people's equality and equal education of men and women. Seemingly, of course, very democratic. However, there emerged a dilemma of Japanese people. On one hand, so much enlightened, mostly westernized concept based on the human rights and democracy and the parliamentary system and etc. On the other hand, which is the reason of the change called Restoration, 1868, there is a proclamation that royal policy now restored in Japanese osefukko. And Tokugawa shogunate, so-called Bakuhan Seido, the central government and local areas daimyo system are changed and revised into the modern concept of prefecture and throw away the old system in any ways. So the, on one hand, symbolized by emperor system, Japanese inherited the traditional historical, whether old fashioned or not, I don't know, anyway, continuance of tradition. And on the other hand, modernization and westernization and new concept of politics and economy so much developed. Through such a historical development in modernity, now I like to show you some case of the women, representative women, which can be classified into three categories. One, the Kaneko Misuzu, Omura Seiko, may be the victim in tragedy. Of course, I don't want to simplify, and I never say they are the victim of the modernization of Japan, but to some extent, I like to interpret their tragedy in relation with Japanese modernization. And the second category, Empress Michiko and Ongata Sadako and Sugano Atsuko, can be regarded as the highest accomplishment in a globe. And the third category, I like to show they representative the case of overcome to beauty or beautifying Uemura Shoen and Sama Yayoi. The first category, the tragic heroine, one case is Kaneko Misuzu. She was a poet. She was born in Yamaguchi Prefecture, but her unhappy career started when his father died suddenly when she was 30 years old. And by partly compelled arrangement of marriage, and one daughter was born, but her husband, I don't know for detail and sure, a very debauchery and dissipation, probably so macho-like, immoral, amoral person. And herself infected gonorrhea from her husband, then decided to divorce. And she claimed parental authority, but cannot be accepted. Then, in protest and in anger, he killed herself by taking poison. Of course, we can find such a wicked man in modern, even in modern history. So the one work by Kaneko Misuzu, she left very, very sentimental and naive poems. Now is very, very fashionable and popular among young girls. So I only cite one example, and the last one, let me translate into English. At first in Japanese. シトコトリとそれから私、みんな違ってみんないい。あ、失礼。スズとコトリとそれから私、みんな違ってみんないい。Rings, birds, and I. These are all different to each other, and they are all good. Very, very simple and sentimental, but whenever we read her poems, so impressive, and we are forced to sympathize with her life. She died 20 at her age. Ah, yes, 27 at her age. Next example, Omura Sueko. She was a graduate of Kobe College I had been working for, and then went on the Tokyo University of Fine Arts, and her skill of piano performance so great, and he went to Europe and the United States, and in United States he worked as a teacher or instructor of piano. And she is the first Japanese who played piano at the Carnegie Hall. So her skill marvelous. So after returning back to Japan at her age of 26, she became the professor of Tokyo University of Fine Arts. However, 1944, at the time the last period of the World War II, one day she took excessive dose of sleeping pill and died. Of course, her mistreating regarded a killing herself, but not sure. Anyway, what was evident at that time, just under the wartime, most teachers and professors in the field of the humanities, and in particular in fine arts, music school at or art school, those teachers and professors are requested to limit the activity and sometimes compelled to resign the post. So Ogura Seiko's tragedy can be called operation against artistic activity, which is almost a similar case with Kaneko Misuzu. Next category, changing our mind, I like to refer to the successful case of three ladies. One is Empress Michiko. She is the first lady who married to a royal family. The current emperor chose the Shoda Michiko, her former name, as his wife, which is a kind of a strategy of royal family and emperor system as promoting the open royal family. However, we can easily imagine she had the difficulty to adapt the very unique situation or custom in the emperor's household and family. So she had a good counselor, the very, very distinguished doctor, Kamiya Mieko, about her depression caused by adapting herself to the new situation. However, seemingly she get over the difficulty and currently a very respectful empress, I think. At the interview by a journalist, when she with her husband, the emperor, is visiting Europe, when she was 70, more than 70 years old. The question is, what do you want to do if you can hide your status as an empress? So her answer is, once again, I like to second-hand bookstores, the very, very famous street of Kanda Jinbocho near Ochanzu in center of Tokyo. And for a long time, read a book standing at the shop. So in her university student days, she very much often, frequently, went to the second-hand bookstores in the Kanda Jinbocho. Such a hobby or such a tendency or such a disease, I can share with her. And next, Ogata Sadako. Ogata Sadako is, of course, she herself academia, but her accomplishment noteworthy at the time of her so-called United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees from 1991 to 2001, so almost 10 years. Generally, such position is kept at length 3 years, but she was so much appreciated and 10 years long stayed that position, and Kurdish refugee and Yugoslavia and Rwanda and etc. etc. She, her activities so noteworthy. And next case, the Suga Atsuko. She is women of literature. After graduating university, she went to Paris, at the University of Paris, to study theology. But she was disappointed by the atmosphere of Paris, then attracted Italian culture, then went to Milano, eventually meet her husband. Though the after 7 years marriage, her husband Giuseppe Ricca Peppino died suddenly. But she continued her work as a translator of Japanese literature into the Italian and the Italian literature into Japanese, such as works of Italo Calvino and Antonio Tabucchi. And as an essayist, she is so much talented. These three women, Empress Michiko and Ogata Sadako and Suga Atsuko, have something in common. One is those three ladies graduate of Seishin Joshi Daigaku, the Women's University of Sacred Heart in Tokyo. It's a Christian university, Catholic university. These three ladies are considered to be a Catholic believer. Of course, in case of Empress Michiko's marriage, her belief on debate, so the compromise of the Shintoist belief and her Christian belief. So again, we can appreciate the contribution of Christianity University in Japan, in particular for women's studies. So Seishin Joshi, Women's University of Sacred Heart can boast of such a product of the education, not only through the university education, but mostly, I think, their family background is so much cultural, so prestigious tradition. So lastly, as the last category, I like to mention Uemura Shoen and Samaya. Yes. Sorry, no photo of Uemura Shoen. She got the highest prize of culture in Japan, so-called Bunka Kunsho, as a lady for the first time, 1948. Of course, her artwork is so impressive and so beautiful. However, in her case, she, since her childhood, she had the difficulty about her family, so unhappy, because just before, 2 months before her birth, she lost his father. So her father, working as a owner of a wholesaler of tea leaf, raised, educated, 2 daughters, Uemura Shoen and his sister. So Uemura Shoen, till the end of her life, stick to her mother and kept a longing for mother. According to her, quote, "Thanks to my mother, I never feel the difficulty of life and supported my activity for painting. Painting means to me life and supporting stick. My mother, who bored me, also bored my art. She didn't get married, but she bored one son. He himself a good painter. Her master, Suzuki Shonen, is said to be the father, but they never married. So Uemura Shoen had been a so-called single mother and raised a so-called love child. It was a very scandalous case in Japanese society. Still, she may have been so patient and overcome her suffering. So I like her masterpieces. This is called Fireflies, 1943, and this is Decoration in Autumn, and this is Beautiful Rhythm. My pronunciation is not good, translation is not good, but anyway. So, worthy of notice is the year the painting was shown. This is in 1943, and this is 1936. Really, nota bene, at the time of the war to Japanese people, while Uemura Shoen concentrated on her artistic creativity and left us, we are fortunate to see her masterpiece. Then lastly, I'll mention Kusama Yayoi. She got the highest prize of culture, Bunkakunsho, last year. She was born in Nagano Prefecture at the family of wholesale seed nurseries, very, very rich family. But her father saw patriarchal oppression to her, and from her mother, physical abuse. So she suffered depression, and she was at a loss for her future at that time. But she was brave enough to send a letter to Georgia O'Keeffe, the greatest American woman artist. You should remember her name, Georgia O'Keeffe. And she received a very, very kind letter, and she was fortunate to accept Georgia O'Keeffe at her exhibition in New York, which means she got the supporter, not in Japan, but outside Japan. And in 1957, she went to United States by herself. And after returning back to Japan in 1973, she has been so active and very, very well known nowadays all over the world. And according to her, quote, "I thought to wear the similar clothes all the young student, I think it very, very feudalistic. So I tried to exclusively queer wear putting." So her mind of revolt against the any Japanese custom and the practice and the system and schooling eventually produce her creative work of art. Of course, Kusama Yayoi, on the hand, says artists themselves never be especially great or especially distinguished species of humankind. So to Uemura Shoen and Kusama Yayoi, art may be a good media to control and to get over their difficulty. So both the winner of the highest prize of culture and nowadays so much respected by fine art lovers all over the world. Of course, it depends on our taste to appreciate her work and artworks, but as we see, such psychedelic colors, the motif of repetition and patterns are so suggestive to our problematic world. That's why she collected greatest number of fans. But we must remind ourselves that she was alienated, and she felt all alone during her younger days in Japan. So abroad, outside Japan, she got the supporter and great fame. It's a, in a sense, Japanese dilemma and the paradox. Now it's about time of to conclude tentatively. I like to mention again the concept of power of womanhood, which implies the greatest soul of woman. And Takamura It's another interesting thinker in a sense of woman studies suggests the concept of motherhood ego. Not a motherhood only, not a feminist or women's right. She wants to base the power of womanhood on her motherhood. So motherhood ego means not a legal privilege, but women's real nature. So such a concept of power of womanhood and motherhood ego is antagonist, so-called woman-likeness in Japanese, onnarashisa, which requests mostly by male leading persons. So I like to suggest we appreciate and we love the female existence, not as a because of supermodel figure and so much fighting spirited feminist activity, but as a very, very common existence and a common mentality, but those who are concentrated on some work and some accomplishment. Those ladies I mentioned today is examples. I like to trace the tradition probably outside the formal governmental system of education or schooling. I like to trace the such a line of greatest women in Japan. Thank you very much. One hour.
Yeah, I'm watching my send a question by text message, but so far I don't have any questions. So, do you any questions from the floor? Yeah, water.
I know a little bit about Murasaki and Samayoi because they're in my field of art history, but I don't know too much about their how they thought about ideals of women's behavior.
Yeah.
And even Samayoi, I mean, she's not depicting idealized women's behavior, but in her art is popular in contemporary art museums where, at least in my own personal experience, a lot of the people going there are young couples on dates.
Yeah.
The other people too, but there's a kind of ritualized behavior going on. So I wonder if you might speak a little bit more about how someone like Kusama feels.
If you know about that, she was so, you know, wonderfully grumpy and acrobatic like this.
Yes. Yes, if we have time, I'd like to show another artworks of Kusama Yayoi. So, can I try now? Lack of time? No, internet, but only from my.
Oh,
how to do that. Concerning the thank you. Concerning the she is considered among the so-called neo-Japanist, Aida Makoto and Murakami Takashi and Narayoshi Tomoa are the member of the artist. So, yes, I like to show you the series of her work. Probably if you put a light, you can see the more clearly. Thank you. Okay. And repetition of the motif, such as to heal herself from mental disease, probably. So we need a pathographic analysis about her creation. But I wonder why her artwork is so much popular among younger people. Probably her creation suggests something we research worker cannot find, but we need to adapt. Such a dot and pumpkin motif. Seemingly grotesque or infinity of the soul. So that's all for the samayayoi. Considering the current sustaining system of academism of art college, they challenge to establish some department for manga creation, anime creation, and IT for dimension, virtual reality work, and so on. So as for myself, as a very, in a sense, authentic or classical type of research of humanities, reading a classical text and philologically and philosophically and interpretation, etc. The another type of mind or the idea may emerge from so much delicate artist. To confess, I cannot catch up the situation, but let's discuss further after the
session. So, any other there will be some lunch. So you can just grab lunch, and then you know, Professor Hamashita will be here until 1. So you can just have lunch, and you know, casually you can ask him questions. Okay. So please help yourself, and there is coffee and tea and sandwiches outside this room. So I will check one more time if there is any questions from the other side. Probably you didn't get any, right? Okay. So in that case, it's okay. Yeah. It's okay. You don't have anything to show.
Yes.
Okay. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much.